Okay, Assalamualaikum. Kita go on to the next topic. Topik 14, yo. Lagi 3 topik kita habis, ha? Generator protection. Protection. So, ini typical generator, ha? Kita ada prime mover, generator ataupun alternator. So the exciter, and then AVR, voltage regulator, and then synchronizer, power factor, kilowatt controller, and then governor nak control minyak ke prime mover, exciter untuk control voltage. Okay, ataupun excitation lah. So this is the typical generator control system. Kadang-kadang tuan juga akan jumpa juga dekat mana-mana plant tu dia pakai asynchronous induction generator. Dia macam dia induction motor biasa je, tapi bila dia punya proses tu means produk yang di drive oleh compressor ataupun di drive oleh pump tu, dia melebihi daripada speed motor tu lah. So dia boleh mengeluarkan kilowatt, tapi VAR masih diperlukan untuk magnetization of the motor punya rotor semua tu lah. Okay, so tu beza asynchronous induction. Dia cuma boleh menghasilkan kilowatt, tapi VAR still kena ambil daripada sistem. Okay, generator earning, kita ada 3 jenis. LV, low voltage, selalunya menggunakan solid earning. Medium voltage, resistor earth. And then distribution transformer, resistor combination lah. So yang ni depends lah. So distribution transformer, yang ni yang last punya type eh. Then single phase transformer with resistor connected to the LV secondary winding. Advantage dia low ohmic value as compared to the direct NER with high ohmic value lah. Terutamanya kalau tuan-tuan nak pakai, okay lah, kita tak satu tu lah. LV earning ni, LV earning ni straight. Ni resistant earning So ni resistant earning LV earning, solid earning biasalah. Tu tak ada apa-apa. MV pakai resistant earning. So kita ada ada NER sini, neutral earning resistor. So normally neutral earning resistor ni dia calculation dia ohm dia untuk limit kepada full load current of the generator lah. So ni bahagian B sini lah, distribution transformer earning with over voltage relay lah. So ni single phase transformer, single phase transformer, then ada loading resistor, then pergi ke over voltage relay. This one is distribution transformer earning with over current relay. Dua-dua ni sama je, cuma cara dia detect tu berlainan lah. So over voltage relay dia letak parallel kepada resistor, so dia akan measure voltage across the loading resistor lah. So under normal condition, kalau tak ada earth fault, so takkan ada current return ke sini. So there will be no current being step up ke step down sini. So tak adalah. So there's no current circulating on the secondary here. Same goes to here lah. So bila ada fault, earth fault, dia akan return back to source. So the current will return back to here and induce a secondary punya current on both side. So the secondary current will trigger either the overcurrent or the over voltage relay. Okay. So apa, kenapa tak pakai JNER kan? So inilah low ohmic value as compared to direct NER. Kalau transformer generator ni setakat 5 MVA, 10 MVA tu NER biasa tu boleh lah. Tapi kalau generator you besar bapak 50 MVA, 100 MVA, even the big generators yang apa nama company dari China tu, TMB dengan Edra, Edra Power tu kan, Edra Power, that one satu train tu about 600 ke 700 megawatt lah. So kalau you nak pakai juga NER, memang besar gila lah NER tu, sebab nak limit kepada full load current lah sebagai contoh kan. So this one would be a much cheaper and smaller solution lah. Okay, to detect earth fault. Okay, so generator, let's talk about the problems first. Sebab kita nak protect, kita kena tahu lah kita nak protect apa kan, daripada apa. So we want to protect against problems, against faults. So the typical system problems yang the generator will experience, overload, loss of load kan, load rejection kan. So macam kat Kertih ni kita ada satu power plant, dia akan selalu merasai ada disturbance bila TMB Jalan Manjung trip. Ha, TMB Jalan Manjung dia buat servis ke, dia tengah test ke, tiba-tiba trip, pang, hilang 1 gigawatt. Kan? So 1 gigawatt, 2 gigawatt, somebody kena take that power. So satu grid kat Malaysia ni kenalah. So even sampai ke Kertih ni pun merasai loss of load dekat TMB Jalan Manjung tu lah. Okay. Second, number 3 is unbalanced loading. Generator unbalanced loading. But not everything is a three-phase punya load. And then under frequency, over frequency, it will also experience under voltage, over voltage. And of course, short circuit lah. These are all system problems. Ni short circuit in the system. Ni bukan dekat generator ni, dekat system lah. Okay, so generator sebab sama-sama connected to the grid has to together with the grid to experience all this lah. And we must, the generator must survive lah. And trip only necessarily lah. Okay, for the generator punya fault, ada insulation failure, can be the insulation failure of the rotor, of the winding, of the stator, of the wedges, semua tu lah. Loss of excitation, tiba-tiba loss of excitation, nah, sila air bulan generator boleh jadi motor kan. And then prime mover governor failure, nah, ni pun sama, boleh jadi menyebabkan generator jadi motor. And then mechanical failure lah, normally due to cooling, insufficient lubrication dengan vibration. So generator overcurrent protection, this is the most basic protection. Semua benda kena ada overcurrent lah, generator ke motor ke apa, overcurrent mesti ada. So main protection for small generators and as backup protection for large units. So preferably overcurrent city to be located at the neutral end of the machine lah. So ni winding lah, dalam ni ada winding red, yellow, blue. So dia located at the neutral point of the, sorry, before the start point of the generator lah. So before the winding lah, before the, between the winding and the start point. So that's the, where the CT is located lah. So difficult to set overcurrent relay because of fault decrement at near generator fault. Okay, kalau ada fault berdekatan dengan generator ni, so this generator, so it's difficult to set overcurrent because near generator faults, the voltage would be very low or would say almost collapse to zero lah. So when voltage collapse to zero, current will be low. So it may or may not trigger the overcurrent punya setting lah. So that's a solution lah. We go on to the next page lah. But before that, okay, so for single generator, that explain already. So for parallel operation, CTs can be located on the line side. On the line side meaning, on the line side lah. And directional record relays may be required for some application lah. Okay. So this is the most basic generator, LV punya type generator. So dia letak 3 CT, red, yellow, blue, overcurrent. This is a unit transformer generator. So generator terus step up kepada kepada ni lah. Contohnya this is 1133 kan. So 11 punya start point, dia akan gunakan start point daripada generator. So belah transformer winding primary jadi delta, secondary is star lah. Okay. So kalau this is 33, this star akan ada NER lah. So as we repeated earlier, for near generator faults, overcurrent may or may not operate. Depending on the remaining voltage during that overcurrent for near generator faults. So we use a relay with voltage dependent characteristic. So it's still considered as overcurrent, but with an additional letter V, 51V, IDMT with voltage dependent. V means voltage dependent. So during the overloads, terminal voltage is high, so relay is slower lah. So during generator close up faults, means near to generator faults, terminal voltage is low and relay is much faster lah. So two types, we have voltage control mode or voltage restraint mode. So for the voltage control mode, when the voltage is high, for example, let's say under normal condition, if the fault is far away from the generator, we say that the voltage can drop between 70 to 100%. So let's say VS here is 70% lah. So any, as long as the voltage above 70%, it will use the normal current pickup level lah. But if the fault is near the generator, so for example at 70% or lower of the voltage, the pickup level will be reduced much further lah to compensate for the reduction of voltage, which will produce a lower generator fault current for near generator faults. So this is the case lah. This is for voltage control mode. For voltage restraint mode, is about the same, but there is a gradient lah to the curve between there's two set points lah. One is the first set point VS1. Anything above VS1 will, so this is assumed for far away generator faults. So as the generator faults, as the fault gets nearer to generator, the multiplier 4K gets lower and lower and lower lah, until it reaches a point where it's constant. So for very near generator faults, is the sensitivity of the overcurrent is reduced to much lower pickup level lah. For example, if this is 100% pickup level, this may be 20-30% of the pickup level lah. So this is voltage restraint mode lah. So for near generator overcurrent protection, we will use 51V, which is voltage dependent IDMT overcurrent. Next is loss of excitation or the field failure. So the generator, for it to induce current in its main rotor, it will require excitation lah from the field and the from the exciter winding. So when the generator loses its excitation, the generator can still continue to operate, but it will operate similar to an induction generator. Rotor needs to run at higher than synchronous speed, means at that time your driver cannot run any more 50 Hz, it may have to run at higher than that. So during this time, when it becomes an induction generator, the VAR for the excitation comes from the grid or comes from the system. But the worst part is that the rotor can quickly overheat lah if it's not controlled properly. Because the VAR is coming from the generator lah, means the VAR comes from the generator and will be induced inside the rotor lah to produce that excitation. So the rotor will heat up quickly lah. So may cause system instability as VAR is consumed from other generators lah. So the protection that we can do is the loss of excitation relay. So it will detect the loss of any excitation lah. So it will trip the generator or running the generator at full speed, no load lah, with no excitation at all lah. Okay. Third is the negative phase sequence protection lah. So three phase currents in a generator are normally balanced. Red, yellow, blue are normally balanced. So they consist, under this condition, they only consist of positive sequence components only. So any unbalance in the system will result in both positive and negative sequence current lah. So this unbalance can be caused due to a earth fault or unbalanced fault in the system, or can also be due to unbalanced voltage in the system. So if there's an unbalanced voltage at the generator terminal due to the system voltage, so it can also produce this unbalanced or negative phase sequence condition. So positive sequence current will create a positive sequence current rotating field in the same direction as the generator rotation. Since the field and generator rotate at the same speed, the field does not induce any current lah within the rotor. However, for the negative sequence current, it will induce double the frequency current in the rotor because of the opposite direction of the rotation in relative to the generator direction. For example, if the positive sequence is in the positive clockwise, So the negative sequence is going on the counterclockwise. So the positive sequence is going on the clockwise at 50 Hz, while the negative sequence is going on the counterclockwise at 50 Hz. So there's a gap between this positive and negative sequence current of about 100 Hz lah. So that is where we say as a double inducing a double frequency lah. So this negative phase sequence current, if not detected or not tripped early, it will cause severe damage to the rotor because of the rotor heating lah. So all motors and all generators, there is a certain limit to negative sequence protection. For example, maybe they can withstand up to 10% or 20% negative sequence current which is being induced within their rotor. So they can sustain that for a certain time. But anything more than that, if it's not if the negative sequence is not tripped earlier, it can produce ni lah, set, it can produce can damage the rotor lah due to heating I squared T or the I squared R of the rotor lah. So the setting of depends on the negative sequence withstand capability of the machine. So a lot of the times small generators, small motors will not provide this kind of data. Typically it's being set between 10 to 40% of the rotor lah. So only big generators or big motor, they will provide what is the negative sequence withstand capability of the machine. So the so this is the component that we are trying to protect against lah. So this should be provided by the motor original manufacturer. So if you don't have it, you can insist on requesting this kind of data from the manufacturer. So this I2 is negative sequence. For positive sequence is I1. For zero sequence is I0 lah. So thermal capacity of the rotor, this data comes from the generator. If not, you can take a typical 10 to 40% lah. So 20% will be a pretty much safe value lah. Okay. So for the detection, you can use either IDMT or definite time. So it depends lah on the kind of protection that you, as long as you treat before it reaches the thermal or the withstand capacity of the negative sequence. So that is the ultimate goal lah of setting the negative sequence protection. Next is reverse power. So reverse power, I always tell the students, reverse power ni nak protect siapa? So when you listen, when you hear the word reverse power, so power, the power always comes from the driver. So it is to protect the prime mover or the driver lah. Because the power comes from the driver lah. So it detects the reverse flow of the real power into the generator if the prime mover loses power. Loses power. So the third generator will become a sync motor lah, a motoring. And this will not do anything to your generator, but it will damage your driver lah. If your driver is a gas turbine, maybe it can rotate on in the opposite direction. But if your generator is a diesel engine, it will for surely damage the pistons and everything lah. Okay. So reverse power is to protect your prime mover or your driver. So the relay measures the power direction. So when there's a power direction, there will be two input, which is your voltage and your current. So from that two parameters, it can measure what is the power direction, whether it's going in or out of the generator, kilowatt . And second is the magnitude of the real power. Okay, so typical setting, this is a typical setting lah. Hydro turbine 0.2 to 2%, steam turbine 0.5 to 6%, gas turbine 10% lah. So far that I found for gas turbine, we set it at 10% of the generator rating lah. If you think it's too big, you can set it lower lah. Even for a 50 megawatt generator at 0.8 power factor, you can just set at 1 megawatt or 2.5 megawatt reverse power . But the best is you have to ask the manufacturer what is the maximum reverse power allowable that the generator can handle lah, which is the driver can handle lah. Okay. So if you are not sure if they cannot give you anything, you can just set 5% to 10% lah of the generator power rating. And normally it's set for about 1 to 3 seconds lah. It depends lah. Okay, that is on reverse power. Then differential relay. So I think all protection, all the types of equipment can have a differential protection. Generator, transformer. So it provides an instantaneous and sensitive protection for instant internal faults. Short circuit and earth fault only, or earth fault only. If you are using only restricted earth fault for the generator. If you are using the normal differential for generator, it can detect both earth fault as well as short circuit. Overcurrent. So it's suitable for both generators and generator transformers. And generator transformer will need interposing CTs lah. This is ni. Old type differential relay. Modern relays is okay. You can interpose mathematically through the setting. Okay, inside the relay lah. And then normally there's no need for a harmonic bias because as voltage builds up when the generator is slowly excited. So when you need, when we start a generator, normally we will build up the generator voltage from 0 up to 100% voltage. So even if this is used for a generator transformer step, generator transformer unit, there's no inrush to the transformer because the voltage build up going to the transformer from the generator is slowly being built up from the generator starting up to full speed from 0% up to 100% voltage. So normally there's no need for a harmonic bias lah. So when the unit is synchronized, no current surge as voltage with mains are in phase and equal. So in large generator transformers, there is sometimes a T-off auxiliary transformer for auxiliary power. So this supplementary differential protection may or may not be required for the auxiliary unit transformer. Let's see. So this is the one that was said just now, the T-off transformer for the auxiliary unit. So typically we can just have a single differential from here going to here lah. But since there is a current loss going through here, so you need also another CT here to measure. So you can see here there's one CT here. For this main differential, we have three sets of CT. 1, 2 and 3 for the main generator transformer differential. Then for the unit transformer, there is another differential protection lah. So here there's a interposing CT as well as here interposing CT and also here interposing CT. This is for old type differential relay lah. But for the new modern type, there's no need for any interposing CT. You do not need to transpose the CT to meet the vector change due to the delta star lah. Or the vector group of the transformer. So there is a case where we had only used the normal differential CT 1, 2 and 3 for this generator transformer. But the unit transformer is too small. For example, this unit transformer in this case was only around 0.4 MVA. And this generator transformer is around 52 MVA. So during the commissioning or installation 20 years back, we found out that the CT sizing for the secondary for this auxiliary transformer was incorrect lah. So due to that, there is very big CT error lah. So when there was a fault at this generator transformer, at this unit transformer, when there's a fault, it wasn't even picked up by the differential relay. So when we saw when we verified the setting and the CT sizing for this differential transformer, differential protection, so it was wrongly sized lah, the CT for this auxiliary transformer lah. So for this kind of generator unit transformer with an auxiliary T off unit transformer, so it's better for you to have a separate differential protection. One set for the main transformer and generator, another set for the unit transformer or the auxiliary transformer lah. Okay. So this is generator, operating coil, bias coil lah. This is the differential transformer lah. And frequency protection lah. So to detect 81O and 81U lah. So this number 81 For ANSI is frequency. O over U under. So why does over frequency happen? So they can be due to sudden load reduction lah. For example, a sudden big loss of load in your system, especially if you're in the islanding mode, suddenly your big motor or your big customer suddenly trip. You lost 18, 20, 30 megawatt out of a 300 megawatt plant. So where does this 30 megawatt go? So this 30 megawatt will be converted, will be reflected in terms of over frequency. So the generator all will respond, but during this response time, maybe a few seconds or a few hundred milliseconds, so your system will experience over frequency. For under frequency, it may be caused by a sudden demand because of loss of a generator, the starting of a large motor, or and this will cause the generator to slow down or overload. If the condition persists, means the demand is much higher than the supply, the generator will have to trip to prevent any mechanical damage. So typically set at 47.5 Hz. So this setting, if you are an IPP, independent power producer, or TNB power plant, so you have to comply to the Malaysian grid code lah. So we have to stay in together up to 47.5 Hz, up to 10 seconds before you can trip or allowed to trip lah. So that everybody will together stay together in the grid until the fault is cleared up lah. In the hope that the fault is cleared up and everybody can stabilize again lah. If not, you have to stay up to 10 seconds lah. So the prime mover in addition also have a mechanical overspeed relay lah. Okay. That is another protection lah. But this is on the prime mover side. Okay, overspeed or mechanical relay lah. So this is a generator typical protection. Let us see. So you have here 27 undervoltage, directional overvoltage. Directional overvoltage power relay, sorry, a fault relay 51G. And then time depend, voltage depend over current, over voltage, earth fault detector or REF, resistor earth fault, over frequency relay 81 and lockout relay, and 96 third harmonic rejection earth fault relay. So this is a typical lah of a generator. This is an LV generator, 1 megawatt generator. So you have your PT here, going to the voltage, which goes to your frequency meter, under voltage relay, over voltage relay. And then here you have your CTs. You have your metering CTs. You have again your metering CTs, and then your protection CTs and your class X CTs. So I'm guessing class X is for the REF lah, 64 here. Then you have your megawatt. So here's 32 is reverse power. So reverse power, they have two inputs. One is from the voltage side, another one is from the current. Same goes for the 51V. Overcurrent with voltage dependent. So it's also measuring the overcurrent plus the voltage. Okay. So that is the generator typical protection. So this is some more of the typical protection for the generator. I'll just look into one of it lah. Which one? So you have here your generator, and here you have your distribution transformer earning resistor. So 59N and also 51N. This is the standby earth fault. So you have also the voltage dependent overcurrent reverse power. And 40, what is 40? Field failure, 46 negative phase sequence. And you do have also your differential protection, over voltage, under voltage, over frequency, under frequency. And 60 is your voltage balance protection. Yeah. And this one is additional 8070 for your transformer protection. And high voltage restricted a fault lah. This is 64H for this one. And transformer differential lah. And 24 is generating plant overfluxing protection. Okay, so these are some of the examples lah of the typical generator protection. So if you think this material is good, please share this material to your electrical friends. And do subscribe to my YouTube channel, KraxofEE, and then my Facebook page. Please like my Facebook page, facebook.com/KraxofEE. And if you have any other questions, please throw them in the comments below, or you can email me directly lah at KraxofEE@gmail.com. Thank you.